Well, let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. The United States is about to host a summit with its longtime allies, Japan and the Philippines. We find out what's in it for the Philippines and the Filipino people.
Special Assistant to U.S. President Joe Biden, Dr. Mira Rapp Hooper, laid out what to expect in the April 11th trilateral summit between the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines. In response to a question whether the U.S.-Philippine Mutual Defense Treaty will cover an attack on the BRP Sierra Madre in the South China Sea, Rapp Hooper says President Biden has made it clear that there is a strong show of support and solidarity among the three leaders when it comes to maintaining international law in the region.
The U.S.-Philippines Mutual Defense Treaty applies to the Philippines in the South China Sea, again, to vessels underway, including Coast Guard vessels. We stand strongly by our alliance commitments to the Philippines.
The trilateral summit will also discuss important issues related to economic investments and infrastructure.
In sports, a Phil-Am gymnast is eyeing an Olympic berth through a world competition in Doha, Qatar.
Fresh from three international competitions representing the Philippines, 17-year-old Los Angeles-born gymnast Levi Joan Ruiz Vivar is hoping her performance on the bars at next week's World Cup in Doha, Qatar, will get her a spot in the Olympics.
I'm currently positioned 4, and I'm about 5 points away from second. And if I get into that second position, then I will secure the spot and qualify to the Olympics. And then if I don't get that spot in Doha, there's also another opportunity for me to qualify during Asian Championships.
After training in the U.S. system her whole life and signing with Stanford University, the Filipina teen who started gymnastics at age 2 joined the Philippine team last year. Ruiz Vivar, who is currently training in Texas, will be heading for Doha later this week, where she will practice leading to the bars competition on April 17th and floor on April 18th. The finals are set for Friday, April 19th.
We go to Texas, where three Filipina teens are taking the volleyball courts by storm as defense specialists or liberos.
18-year-old Bea Angeles and 17-year-olds Francesca Colocado and Daniela Lang play liberos, or defensive specialists, for the Absolute Volleyball Academy Texas 18 Adidas. Out of 2,282 teams in the U.S., they are ranked 28th. And out of 95 teams in the Texas Lone Star region, they are ranked 5th. It's a rarity for Filipinos to all play as defensive specialists or liberos in one team, especially one that is nationally ranked. This January, they bagged the Lone Star Classic National Qualifier 18's USA Division gold medal in Austin, Texas. In March, they won the silver medal at the Powerade Caribbean Volleyball Championships 18's Open Division in Puerto Rico.
My family, they've worked so hard. Obviously, they were from the Philippines, so bringing them here, I just want to like be able to work hard for them and like give back to them.
You really cannot be successful on your own in this sport, and that's something I really love about it. It's because you form such a unique connection with the people around you.
It's the culture that we have, the competitiveness, the just love for we have for one another and want the best for each other is what wants me to come to the practice every day in this building.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
A New York appeals judge denies Donald Trump's third attempt this week to delay his April 15 hush money trial. Trump's lawyers have argued the trial should be delayed because Justice Juan Merchan, who is overseeing the case, has not yet ruled on the request to recuse himself. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office, however, says the request was brought too late. On Monday, a judge at the appellate division denied Trump's request to delay the case while he pursues a challenge to the trial being held in heavily Democratic Manhattan. Another judge on Tuesday rejected his bid to pause the trial while he appeals Mershon's decision to impose a gag order. Those appeals will still be heard by a full panel. Three sons of Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh killed in an Israeli airstrike in the Gaza Strip Wednesday. The Israeli military confirms carrying out the attack, describing the three sons as operatives in the Hamas armed wing. Israel, however, says it has no information on reports. Four of Haniyeh's grandchildren were also killed in the airstrike. Relatives say the three sons and four grandchildren were making family visits during the Muslim Eid al-Fitr holiday. U.S. President Joe Biden urging Hamas to accept the latest proposal for a temporary Gaza ceasefire in exchange for the release of some hostages. Hamas has said it was studying the Israeli truce proposal, although it met none of Palestinian demands. Hamas wants an end to Israeli military operations and a withdrawal from the enclave and permission for displaced Palestinians to return home.
I have been very blunt and straightforward with the Prime Minister, as well as his war cabinet, as well as the cabinet. And the fact of the matter is that Bibi and I had a long discussion. He agreed to do several things that related to, number one, getting more aid, both food and medicine, into Gaza, and reducing significantly the attempts, the civilian casualties in any action taken in the region.
Problems hounding the Indo-Pacific front and center as leaders of the U.S., Japan, and the Philippines meet for their highly anticipated trilateral summit. Speaking at the White House, U.S. President Joe Biden said ensuring a free Indo-Pacific will be prioritized as the three countries showcase their growing partnership. Thursday's summit is widely expected to focus on China's maritime incursions as the U.S., the Philippines, and Japan seek to deter Beijing's aggressive behavior.
Today, I look forward to discussing how we can even deepen it more, including increasing defense and then technology and cooperation across the board. And we can also discuss how we can continue to enhance and ensure Indo-Pacific remains a free, open, and prosperous region of the world with us standing together. And thank you for being here, Mr. Prime Minister. You've heard me say this before, but I'll say it again. You're a genuine leader, a true partner, and a good friend. Thank you for being here.
Biden and Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida met at the White House Wednesday in the lead-up to their trilateral summit with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Biden said Washington's military upgrade with Tokyo is the most significant yet since their alliance began.
Together, our countries are taking significant steps to strengthen defense security cooperation. We're modernizing command and control structures, and we're increasing the interoperability and planning of our militaries so they can work together in a seamless and effective way. I'm also pleased to announce that for the first time, Japan and the United States and Australia will create a network system of air, missile, and defense architecture.
President Marcos is expected to arrive in Washington, D.C. around 7:55 a.m. Manila time. Like the U.S. and Japan, Marcos said the Philippines will strengthen its cooperation with the two countries, both on the economic and security fronts. Aside from their trilateral summit, Marcos will also hold a bilateral meeting with Biden and meet with American investors during his U.S. trip.
It is my intention also to exchange views with my U.S. and Japanese counterparts on various regional security issues of mutual concern, while continuing to reiterate the importance of upholding the rule of law and preserving the rules-based international order in the Indo-Pacific region. I intend to explore ways of advancing cooperation, especially in the areas of critical infrastructure, semiconductors, digitalization and cybersecurity, critical minerals, renewable energy, as well as defense and maritime cooperation.
The Philippines seen bagging huge investment deals during the historic trilateral summit in Washington. Philippine Ambassador to the U.S. Jose Manuel Romualdez says the U.S. and Japan are expected to pour in at least $100 billion into the Philippines in the next 5 to 10 years. The investment package will cover various sectors including energy, semiconductor, and infrastructure.
This meeting is not only important, but it is also significant. Aside from the defense strategies that we have put in place, the enhancement of our economic cooperation with Japan and the United States is just as important. The energy exploration, of course, which involves the West Philippine Sea, is also is part and parcel of what we're looking at as to bump up our energy requirements, which should be which is increasing every year.
Washington was Manila's fourth largest source of foreign direct investments last year, amounting to $110 million. It also ranked as the country's third biggest trading partner in 2023, with a total trade of nearly $20 billion. Japan, meanwhile, is the Philippines' largest source of official development assistance, with nearly $13 billion in aid, or about 40% of the country's total portfolio. President Marcos also seeking investments from nuclear power firms on the sidelines of the trilateral summit. Philippine Ambassador Jose Manuel Romualdez says Marcos will be speaking with several companies, including American firm UltraSafe Nuclear Corporation. Marcos earlier said he sees nuclear energy becoming a part of the country's energy mix by 2032. Last year, the Philippines and the U.S. signed a landmark agreement that would facilitate cooperation on the peaceful use of nuclear energy.
The more exciting part of the clean energy projects that we're trying to lure into the country is the small modular nuclear power plants. We have 7,640 islands, and this is going to be perfect for us. It's much safer. It's cleaner, and at the same time, it is a very new technology.
Before leaving for Washington, President Marcos summoned Beijing's envoy in Manila to seek an explanation of the supposed South China Sea deal between his predecessor and Chinese leader Xi Jinping. Pia Gutierrez reports.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says he's horrified by the idea of a so-called secret gentleman's agreement supposedly entered into by his predecessor, former President Rodrigo Duterte, with Chinese President Xi Jinping on the West Philippine Sea.
I am horrified by the idea that we have compromised through a secret agreement the territory, the sovereignty, and the sovereign rights of the Philippines. Filipina.
Former Duterte spokesperson attorney Harry Roque earlier revealed that the former Philippine leader agreed with Chinese President Xi Jinping to keep the status quo in the West Philippine Sea. The deal, he says, includes not to undertake repairs in the BRP Sierra Madre, the grounded Philippine warship which serves as the Philippines' lone outpost at the Ayungin Shoal. But Marcos Jr. says they do not have any information whatsoever about this deal.
Well, it turns out we don't know. It is a secret agreement. We don't know anything about it. There is no documentation. There is no record. There is no. We were not briefed when I came into office. Walang nagsabi sa amin na mayroong ganung usapan. Hindi pa namin alam kung ano ba talaga yung agreement na yan. But kung ang sinasabi sa agreement na yan na kailangan tayong magpermiso sa ibang bansa para gumalaw sa ating sariling teritoryo, ay mahirap sigurong sundan yung ganyang klaseng agreement.
The president says he is currently seeking clarification from former administration officials. He has also summoned Chinese ambassador to the Philippines Wang Xilian to shed light on the matter.
That is something. We still have to clear it up. We are waiting for Ambassador Wang to come back from Beijing na umalis siya, and I asked to see him. Baka siguro sa pagbalik na. At ipaliwanag niya, sino bang kausap mo? Sino ba talagang kausap mo? Anong pinag-usapan ninyo? Anong pinag-agrihan ninyo? Was this an official thing or was it a personal thing? Ano ba ito? Dahil wala kaming record. Kahit saan ka tumingin,
walang record. So sikretong ginawa lahat ito. Bakit nila ginawa? Kung gagawin man nila, ba't pa nila ginawang sikreto? Nakakapagtaka nga eh. Kaya it's not a good situation.
Alibi Representative Edsel Lagman agrees with the president in saying that the supposed secret deal is a grave mistake and compromises Philippine sovereignty. He says there can be no gentleman's agreement with a chronic aggressor like China in the West Philippine Sea, adding that the deal has no binding effect. Duterte's other former spokesperson, Attorney Salvador Panelo, has denied the existence of the supposed gentleman's agreement. In a recent statement, he insisted that the former president has never and would never enter into any agreement that is against the Philippine national interest, sovereignty, and territorial integrity. He claims Marcos Jr. has been misinformed and misled on the matter, as he warned against those who spread false news and bogus narratives. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
China asserts there has never been any problem with freedom of navigation in the South China Sea. That statement coming from Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesperson Mao Ning in reaction to the upcoming trilateral summit in Washington, which President Marcos says will also include an agreement to maintain security and freedom of navigation in the South China Sea.
Thanks to the joint efforts of China and ASEAN, the South China Sea has basically maintained peace and stability. Some countries outside the region, led by the United States, are constantly forming small circles in the South China Sea to engage in confrontation in the name of cooperation, flex their muscles in the name of peace, and create chaos in the name of order.
Beijing claims sovereignty over nearly the entire South China Sea, despite competing claims from other countries, including the Philippines.